Everyone, it's Ross, and we're doing a lot of things outside today. There's a lot to get done, a lot of things to go over. We got things in this bin here. These are my tomatoes that we started. I think we started these February 1st. We're going to be putting these in larger pots, actually burying the stems quite deep, taking off the lower leaves here. We'll do a video on that. We're also starting another seed tray here. A lot of this tray will be of alpine strawberries. For those of you guys who don't know what alpine strawberries are, they're an incredible type of strawberry. They're smaller, they're softer, and they have a very intense flavor. But anyway, this video is actually going to be about bringing our fig trees outside and putting them on the patio. We talked about the fig tree timeline and really the whole process of what needs to be done throughout the entirety of the year. We just released that. We put that on the blog, so if you want to go on the website, rossratty.wixsite.com/blog. You can also find it on my other social media accounts, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. You can see the timeline. We did one for the winter as well, just breaking down all the things that you guys are going to need to expect with your fig trees in the winter time. So now we're in the spring. Today was daylight savings time, or I should say this morning. So it is March 10th, and now we're thinking about bringing the potted figs out of storage. And these are the dormant ones, okay? So in the timeline, I had mentioned two different strategies that you could use. The first strategy is coming down in here and taking out your dormant trees and putting them on the patio sometime around May 1st. Maybe March 15th for my area. What this is gonna do is, and I can't really show you guys me bringing out all these pots. It's gonna be a lot of work. These things are all 15 gallons. There's some 10 gallons in here. It's a lot of work, and I can't really film it for you guys, unfortunately. We are gonna bring out even the smaller pots, as long as the tree is dormant. So this one here, the Smith that we had stuck in here, is not dormant. We're not gonna bring that out until our last frost. Okay, so anything with leaves or anything that's budding, you know, any growth that is potentially growing here, the tree is not dormant. In no circumstance should I let these sit out here on the patio and potentially get hit with a frost. Okay, so that's what's on the agenda for today, is that we are going to bring a significant portion of what's underneath the sunroom here that is dormant and just stick them on the patio. And the whole goal with this, the whole reason why I'm doing this, and this is a bit of an experiment, okay? I don't know exactly how well this is gonna work, because there is a potential that these trees could wake up before our last frost. So our last frost is on average, I think a safe date is probably May 1st. Sometimes it's well before that. It's been well before that the last 2 years. But I would say the safe date is May 1st. And I don't want these trees to wake up too soon. What I want to happen is to get these trees out here on the patio, just line them up. It doesn't even really matter. Any old fashioned. Maybe I'll stick them against the house, give them a little bit more warmth. But essentially, I want to kind of acclimate them to the conditions outdoors. Here's a great example. These are my jujubes and my chay tree here. The Che is still with me, for those of you guys who have been wondering. But the jujubes wake up last. They're the last thing in my yard to wake up every single year without fail. I would also say persimmons and mulberry, persimmons and figs, I should say, I'm sorry, are one of the last things to also wake up. So knowing that these things just take a long time to do their thing, I kind of want to get them out here, transition them really smoothly, so that when our last frost date, May 1st, actually comes, these trees are awake and doing their thing and not being held back. And this happens every year, it seems, that my jujubes, some persimmons, and even the figs specifically will just sit out here on the patio for like the beginning half of May and not really do anything. And therefore, I'm wasting about 2 weeks of the season for those particular trees. So that's really the goal, is to kind of hydrate the soil, is really the idea behind it, is that by hydrating the soil, giving these guys a bit more heat, they are going to naturally wake up a bit smoother. Now, what would happen if I were to do this and this were to fail, right? I bring the trees out on the patio. They wake up too soon, and then a frost is going to come in. Well, then I have to get those trees, because they started leafing out, they started budding out, I have to stick them underneath the sunroom, or I have to cover them. I have to put some plastic on them, maybe some moving blankets. We also have this tarp here. We actually have the tarp that was on top of the greenhouse. So we can maybe make this a bit more smoother if that were to happen. But the ideal goal, and maybe I'm doing this a bit too soon, so maybe I'll only do this with a couple trees. You know, I won't kill myself today getting all these trees out of here. Because it is a really nice bend. I had to bend my head down in here to get underneath, to then drag the trees out, bring them up here onto the patio, and then move them wherever I want. It is a bit of a work, so, you know, I don't want to be shuffling these things. I don't want to do the fig shuffle more than I have to. That's why we have the greenhouse with the heater in there. So that's, I guess, step one of the timeline. This is step two, or part of step one. This is an either or thing. So if you missed the other part of this, which is essentially talking about the fig shuffle, we talked about how I'm turning on the heater in the greenhouse, how all that's gonna work. You can see over here, just to give you guys a little bit of an update, I should. It's now, we're past the cold. We had a 9 or 10 degree Fahrenheit low just about 3 or 4 days ago on the 7th of March. And you can see that the greenhouse now doesn't have the tarp on top. Yesterday, believe it or not, it was 110 degrees in here during the day. I screwed up. But you can see how fast that this greenhouse will heat up. We've kicked the heater on down in here, and we're really just keeping it on at night to keep the temperature in the greenhouse above 60, and that's really it. If I can keep those nighttime temperatures high, as high as I can, the heater should shut off during the day, and the sun can take over and fill in the gaps with the heat. And, you know, 60 degrees is really a great temperature. Actually, you know what? Let me show you guys if the trees are awake, because I haven't even gotten to check. I just got home, and I actually want to see what is awake in here. We turned on the heater actually a day or two after we did the video. It's quite hot in here. But look at that. This persimmon here has certainly woken up. We've got a Braba now showing. What variety is this? Looks like Strawberry Verte. One of my favorite varieties. There's another Braba back here. That's pretty cool. Never seen Strawberry Verte Braba, to be honest with you. That persimmon's awake. That persimmon's awake. Or pomegranate. I'm sorry. These are all pomegranates. The pomegranates seem to wake up well before the figs do. But so far, the figs have not really budged, other than this particular pot. And the reason for that is because this pot is right in front of the greenhouse, right in front of the heater. Looks like this pot has woken up. This is a Braba forming right there. What variety is this? Thermalito from my buddy Doug. Pretty cool. The heater actually is putting out heat as we speak. And I have it set to, I believe, 60 or 55. So it isn't really the warmest day outside currently. It's only about 50 degrees out here. You can see there's another tree back there which is putting out Braba. I know that's tough to see, but we'll do more updates on how the greenhouse is coming along in time. But I wanted to show you just how far along things are, because we've only really just woken them up. We just really turned on the heater about, I would say, sometime on the 4th. So it hasn't really been that much time that the heater's been on, maybe 5 days total, which tells me that, okay, that's really not a whole lot of time for a lot of these things to wake up, but you can definitely see the pomegranates have. And this is exactly more to my point as to even though the fig trees have been getting blasted with heat and that greenhouse has been above 60 for 5 days straight, they haven't woken up. So even though I'm gonna put them here on the patio and they're gonna sit here, it's still gonna get cold at night, right? We're still expecting temperatures, you know, sometime around, you know, 32 degrees, even mid 20s. I would expect even low 20s. But low 20s are okay. As long as the tree's dormant and the temperatures are above 17 degrees Fahrenheit, your fig trees will be okay. They won't take any damage. Everything will be fine. And that's really all a part of the timeline. So if you have more questions, I would say go watch that video. We did a video. Go look at the blog. Go look at the other forms of social media, and you'll see exactly what I mean in terms of this timeline that I'm referring to. Okay, guys, I gotta get to up potting these tomato plants, filling in this tray here with soil. We're also gonna fill in some soil along this bed because we're creating a new garden bed back in there. And yeah, this time next week, we are gonna be planting out our first crops of the season. A lot of our cool oven crops, things like onions, broccolis, cabbages, all kinds of Asian greens, lettuces. You can see right there, that's the start of the onions hardening off, getting ready to be transplanted. All right, guys, cool video. Excited to see what's gonna happen this year. I'll talk to y'all soon. See you every Mars video. Take care.